terrific avalanche. Was he injured or not? I was stomping my way through the murky snow in the towering Mount Everest when the nature attacked me with a treacherous blizzard. I hid behind a humongous rock to cover myself. After the miserable blizzard was over, I scampered my way through the snow. Yet I didn't know that the nature had some more complicated plans for us. The blizzard was just the tip of the iceberg. Crash! My feet treaded on the scorched hoary leaves. I started to feel more nippier as I moved to the peak of the majestic Mount Everest in Nepal. The gorgeous sight of red pandas and Himalayan black bear was a thing to google at. The charming leaves flew high over the surrounding mountains. I was full of beans to climb the immense mountain. After I scampered my way through the thick part of the mountain, I found a trekking group. They were deciding whether to continue the journey or not due to the blizzard. I befriended with them, had a conversation, and then decided to continue the journey. While on our journey, we met an old and weak Sherpa who warned us there is going to be a snowy avalanche up there. Yet, we were so excited that we ignored his warning. A few months later, ahead on our way, we heard the sound boom, 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 and then crash. The mountain started trembling treacherously. The fog started to rise like a heavenly body. The fog nearly blinded us. We couldn't see anything except the white foggy blanket which covered our eyes. Suddenly, the fog started broken into 1,000 pieces, and my team and I went tumbling down in the tremendous mountain like Jack and Jill. We all descended down like crashing aeroplanes. It all happened so suddenly that we could barely think of any survival tactics. And then my friend, Roy Johnson, struck an idea. He told us to remove our axes and clobber it against the rigid surface of the humongous mountain. At last, we were safe. Or not? My mountain axe was an old and rusted while it lost its grip. Then I fell down again horrendously. Yet, God had saved me. I landed on a blanket of soft alpine flowers. I was about to take a breath of relief when I saw that the part of rocky and miserable mountain on which my team had safely clobbered themselves fell apart and was all crashing down dreadfully. I could see them for a while, but then they disappeared completely. Yet I had sustained many injuries, a fractured elbow and a broken leg. I was hospitalized for 6 months. Not knowing the whereabouts of my team, I tried to trace a few of them, but in vain. Though in this breathtaking journey, I missed my team and also had learned to be more sensitive and courageous in the snowy avalanche.